What started out as a childhood dream to become the best in the world is now reality. In the small Canadian town of Osoyoos, British Columbia, J.F. Lanier has been building cars well before he could drive them, dreaming of the day he would take home the coveted Ridler Award. In the high-stakes game of custom cars, Canada's premier custom car builder, J.F. Lanier, is on a mission to come out on top at the prestigious Autorama in Detroit, Michigan, and take home the coveted Ridler Award.
It'd be like creating Frankenstein. I can't stop it anymore.
Timing is everything.
I think there's a lot of reasons why it's my time, why it's my turn. I think I'm more mature than I've been in the past. I'm ready for it.
A Canadian has not won the prize in over three decades.
It's real simple. Winning the Ridler is a game changer. We're not just playing with cars up here. We are serious in Canada, and there is some great talent up here that needs to be recognized in the industry.
Any dream does not come without its sacrifices.
I've sold everything I can. I've maxed out every bit of credit that I have personally. I've maxed out friends and family's credit. I'm going to sell my soul if I have to get there.
Without deep pockets, it's financial suicide.
It's near impossible to take a car and go play with the guys at the Ridler Award. It's something that costs millions upon millions of dollars, and it's a battle that we're trying to fight on a small budget.
Pursuit of the coveted award has bankrupt many.
You know, I'm flat broke.
And the bank calls for money every day.
To play at the level that we're trying to play at in this industry takes big money.
Running on desperation, Plan B has to be set in motion.
I'm Gord. I'm the money man. I just take risks, and I take a lot of risks.
Art and commerce have always had a difficult time coexisting. On one side is the dreamer, on the other, the financier.
I know it's hard for you to see, but I've got this all figured out. It's all in my head, and I can do it.
And I wanted to see something, and I didn't really see anything.
God, Gord, you got to be able to see how amazing this is.
Oh, nice.
Well, then we got a windshield. Like, we've got all the, most of the parts, Gordy.
This car is somehow going to get to Detroit. I've got a lot of money tied up in it, and I'm not totally convinced he can do it. Go ahead and fail.
You know what?
Go ahead.
No. That's
yeah.
Not fair. I'm going to kill you. I'm not going to fail.
Any unprecedented project does not come without its share of problems.
We don't really have a car yet. We're missing a whole bunch of upholstery. We're missing two wheels. There is no wheels on the car. It's still stuck on this stupid dolly. We're really under the gun. Everybody's working as hard as they can. We have volunteers from all over the place coming to help us. I just don't know if we're going to be able to make it.
It does not look good.
My f***ing head is going to
this up real bad. I don't even know what to do with this thing.
There's wiring hanging around. It's a great way to start a fire. Ah, who set up my f***ing welder?
The clock is ticking. It's do or die.
I think I feel like a bubble that's ready to burst. If you wanted to make me cry, all you'd have to do is poke me at this point. I'm just basically a mess. It's just hard to keep it all together.
JF has been dealt the biggest blow yet. After countless hours and lack of quality sleep, fatigue has finally set in, taking its toll on the crew. Just minutes before loading the car into the trailer, the car's brakes fail, and it rolls into the metal garage door.
Well, the brakes don't work. Well, I guess I know what I'm doing when I get to Detroit.
With absolutely no time to repair the damage to the front end, the car must be loaded onto the trailer for its three-day trek. The repairs will have to be corrected in Detroit.
Goodbye. See you on the other side.
Revision is everything it was dreamt to be. But is it enough?
Driven to the point where you want it so bad that you can't think of anything else.